thinking around this. Five options were put forward to the community. All five, let's build five-story parking garage, right? All five options, we're building a parking garage right on against the five stories. All five. That's not options. They had their other alternatives. And the design element is not thought into it. I asked them about it. They're not thinking design. They'll pick one, we know which one they'll pick, and they'll paint it up, and that they call that design. That is not design. Design is making sure the cycle paths that lead to our sustainable university work. Design is making sure that pedestrians can cross safely. Not, I like roundabouts. Roundabouts are good for cars. Roundabouts are not good for pedestrians. I've lived a long time in Europe. I'm happy with roundabouts for cars. The place where this is being conceived of putting is a very heavy pedestrian zone. There are lots of students walking into the university. This is not the place to put it. So I went to this conference, I heard this guy talk about sustainability, I heard him talk about how we get beauty into our lives, and I said, you are the guys that should be hearing this. So I'm transmitting that message with the request that as you make the decisions that you have to make over the coming, about our budget, you don't need to spend $4 million on Mackenzie Avenue. Please don't keep my taxes lower, that would be helpful. You don't need to do it, especially until we figure out what you're going to do with other intersections along Mackenzie. So thank you for listening to me. I appreciate very much the opportunity to speak directly to you, and I wish you all the best in your deliberations. Thank you very much.
Just want to say it's becoming a little bit like the candidate picnic on the gorge. That is a really good community thing to have for all. I think it's
really turned out amazing.
And don't they give the money to charity or something?
2,000. I'm writing 2,000.
Yep, 2,000.
Oh, there's still more.
I'd be willing to support the two. I agree with Paul. It's becoming a signature event. On the other hand, it's the event where they may $50,000 probably. Of the appreciated kind of event, the same.
running in order to start.
I think we'll need to.
No, I think the personnel issue is separate from the one-time for project.
Yeah.
So that.
This is one time for the project, the bridge.
Yeah.
And also go for it, 25.
Yeah, I agree, it's our, yeah.
Okay. Anyone object to the 20? Support host, $2,500?
Yeah.
Yeah, same.
Anyone object?
Do you need to leave?
Just.
So, okay, just to hang on a second, minutes will show, Council Brett, left the meeting. Whatever percentage increase that is, I can't.
No, same as last year. We've asked our staff to hold the line, I'd ask Silver Cliffs to hold the line.
Anybody object?
I object.
Yeah.
Oh.
As the liaison.
Silver Cliffs, yeah.
Yeah.
I say give the whole thing.
We've cut a lot of already.
They haven't got their other grants, the gaming grants and such.
All right.
What is life and fair?
I mean, I know, I don't, I'm not, it's not worth.
I think what it does send a message, we're not talking about a lot of money, but we're just saying, we don't want to see it keep going up.
I think I might be comfortable giving $1,000.
For 2%?
Yeah. Basically.
This amounts to.
What is that percentage?
It's around 5 to 6.
Two, yeah, 2% is 55,936.
We have to keep that in the back for you as we go down the list.
Yeah, because I think we're.
55,936 is 2%.
What did we just tell people? If you didn't want an increase, you didn't have to come.
Yeah.
It was less than 3.
Oh, okay.
Less than 3?
Yeah.
Okay.
So it's a 3%?
So 3%.
56,276.
56,276?
On 3%?
That's 3%, yeah.
Anybody object to 3%? Okay, that's that, ask Susan to come back. Susan?
Come on back.
We have a cover time.
Okay, we don't have to do anything for the tree committee?
No.
St. John Ambrose?
Same as last year.
Same as last year, as suggested, anybody object?
No.
Okay.
Sorry, Frank, is that a special that they've asked for more? I can't.
It was special capital, they wanted more material.
Yeah, there's nothing specific.
Same as last year then?
Yeah. Okay, Saanich Volunteer Services is definitely less than 3%.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So the 55,6.
55,698.
So we're okay with that?
Yeah.
Anybody object? No. I'm going to stop writing this down. Saanich Marine Rescue Society?
Same as last year.
Same as last year.
Same as last, anybody object? No. The Legacy Foundation is weaning off?
Yeah.
$2,000.
$2,000.
Too much?
Well, they're.
We agree, like, but they're weaning.
They're reducing it by $1,000, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What is?
Now, the Heritage Foundation.
They need that because of the increases, yeah, so.
It's application based.
It's application based, so.
If it is, and if I could mention, I'm really wondering why we have them on here anymore, because they really are carrying out a function, there's a policy of council to support heritage houses, and they just are there as an arm's length, so that we're not seen to be doing it on a political basis. And they are also now an advisory committee to council, because of our reorganization. So it seems funny that we have them asking us for a grant to carry out a granting program as part of our policy. But for this year, it is an application-based system, and they've had more applications.
It's $70,000.
Is it more of an information to council, though, makes us aware?
Well, it's a foundation, we're giving a grant to a foundation.
Yeah.
We have to do it just to keep above the board.
I guess so, we appoint all the members.
It would still require council decision at some point to move money into a foundation.
Can we maybe have a look at that for next year?
Yeah, because it's head of community request, which is not really, is it?
No, give them this year, I think.
Well, you could have them come the same night as Swan Lake.
Yeah.
Yeah, it might be.
If you want to give them different status, so they don't have to line up in alphabetical.
Yeah.
It'll probably be more accurate as to where they actually are.
So put them with Swan Lake and the Hort Center on that same night. Okay. Prospect Lake, Todd Creek?
Agree, yeah.
No one object? Okay. Our place isn't there anymore. The $500 for the fair?
Yeah, for the
Might be 100.
Yeah, no one object. Needs two. We struggled with this over the years.
Yeah, 10,000 also.
Same as last year.
Yeah.
Okay. Anyone object? So, because the other one's gone.
Yeah.
Maritime Museum.
Same as last year.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Anyone object to the same as last year? Okay. Dean it is. Court Center.
Yeah.
Flatline. Okay. Anyone object? No. Halliburton Organic Farm.
Same as last year.
But.
Yeah, I want to point out too that they've got a matching grant in as well.
Yeah, they do every year.
Oh, on top of the five.
Yeah, so we need to clarify, you can't double dip on our grants, and that's the issue.
Okay, so but this page is five?
Yeah.
Okay. Economic Development Agency?
Same as last year.
Okay, 30. Goward House?
I agree with the 20 because I think that was a special request
for a capital project.
Yep. Have you been on the deck? It's very scary.
You might get sent to the deck. Sorry.
So. You people decide what you want to do.
Yeah. 20,000.
It's our.
I'm going to take it out of the next one.
The next one.
Oh,
okay.
Same as last.
Yeah. Three, seven.
I think we should take them off.
So tell me about the Easter seals. Why has it gone up 500? Was it?
Because UVic is charging them more.
I know.
That
is frustrating.
Is something that
I asked you, Vic, and they're giving a lot to this relay.
Why don't they give all of it? It's a charity for crying out loud.
They're giving
the summer when stuff.
Anyway, I've asked them to provide us with something.
And it's for management fees.
Yeah.
So we asked that question when the presentation came.
So $3,500 a
day? Yeah.
I think we see another situation, so where senior levels of government are cutting back, where gambling revenue is going down, so they come to us for more. And I think we have to be careful that we don't pick up the slack. They're a great organization, but.
What's your call?
There's
three of your injection. Or there's 3,500, I'm not suggesting anybody object.
Which is a flow through to you, Vic.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Okay, sure. Right, I believe the way.
I told 3,000.
As a statement of principle to UVic, I'd say
3,000.
I don't know if we're hurting UVic and I'm supposed to.
Yeah. They can give a bit.
Okay. Three. Anybody object to 3,000? Okay. Social Planning Council, that looks well under.
Support and request.
Okay. 20467. Chris Coleman's gone. Contribution to Canada Day.
Support.
Yeah.
So, do we send down the same amount to police?
Yeah.
Because this is for the fireworks.
This is a cash contribution and a significant police contribution.
Okay.
Resources. We send a lot of reserve, and I forget how many. Okay.
Used to get it through the
I know. But again, I'd like to make note for next year. I'd like us to have a conversation in advance about donations that we give that basically flow through to another charity. And, you know, if we're going to give to a charity, we should give to the charity. I think this makes sense. These folks have been doing it for years and they used to get their money a different way, but there's a number of these that came through, and it seems strange to me to flow funds through another way to get to that charity. It doesn't seem efficient.
I'm a little worried. It's one thing to do this as a one-off, but if people are putting on a charitable golf tournament and they know that they can get sued over nothing with a grant back, or if they go to other golf courses they have to pay, we're going to attract even more. this is an unusual year of transition, but I think I wouldn't want this to be the precedent that what the golf course charges people for a tournament is going to be recovered from a grant from us, and then in effect the golf course is free.
But then wouldn't you have to also look at the swimming one and other ones where we do annually?
Well, that's the one-off that I'd like to get out of at some point, the hospice one.
The hospice one, we give concrete here.
I think the hospice is a one-off, but I mean, there's a lot of golf tournaments that pay, you know, Olympic View or Bear Mountain or wherever you go, and you pay $100 or whatever it is.
So maybe council just needs a policy on those things that use our facilities and get a reduction.
Or the rate, I don't know what the rate is for a golf tournament at the golf course, but it has to be the rate, and you don't come and get a grant to make it free.
I think there's a good rationale for this as a year of change. It's supportable for that reason. But beyond that, we have this conversation virtually every year, but we haven't yet done the thing that I think we need to do, and that's probably sit down with almost a all-afternoon seminar or something sometime, really take a look at the grant program and saying, what are we trying to accomplish here? What makes sense? Because a awful lot of this is historical precedent, the squeaky wheel, the person who had the call to come forward, whatever it may be. And I'd like to do that, to look at the philosophical basis of what we're trying to accomplish with that grant. So I'll just leave that out there. That's not for tonight, obviously.
I
mean, Susan.
Yeah.
I support those, frankly.
I think we left it out there last year too, and you had a notice going out this year. If you don't have an increase, don't bother coming and asking us for it. We'll give it. To me, that's not revising.
We're going to have to say this. Well, she's right here listening. So.
I can't hear you anymore.
Oh, I'm sorry. Oh.
We're
saying that it sounds like there's agreement this year, but it would not set a precedent for future years.
Okay.
Susan?
I was just going to, on that theme, say that I do support it for this year. I do think we need to rethink it, but I think it would be very unfortunate if that message were misinterpreted, particularly in this very sensitive year with the golf course. So I'm delighted that we have someone here in attendance, but I would hope that we would find some way of sort of formally informing, because we've had this conversation here about this particular issue around waiving fees for golf tournaments, and that it's not something we can get into, it's not sustainable on a go-forward basis, that be handled very carefully, so that there's no misunderstanding and that there's people are invited in to have a discussion with our administration or whatever, so that there's no sense of lack of support for either the worthy cause or for the golf course.
So we should ask our management to work through this issue of the fees for tournaments so that we don't have people lining up here simply trying to get the money back for what it costs to have a charitable tournament this year, or a charitable event in any rec center for that matter. Okay, so the five is there, but there's lots of conversation we're trying to communicate. So the next one is the Aviation Museum.
Zero.
Zero.
Nil? Anyone care to nil? Okay. And bike work?
Same as last year.
No object. Done. Okay. So we were a bit over budget, but not. We're 20,000 over budget.
We're actually.
What did we do with the Heritage Foundation? Did we move that in or?
Well, but it's still on the list. Your budget was $500,310 and we're at $519,935. Close.
Mm-hmm. We're almost the same as we were in 2010, actually.
Yeah.
I mean, given inflation,
that's probably the bridge, Swan Lake. Yeah.
Goward House and the Swan Lake.
Yeah, a couple of one time.
Yeah.
I will move approval of the numbers that we
step out for that.
Well, we're still in committee. What am I doing? Do I need a motion for this list from committee to council?
Okay, so you're going to get a...
What you have done before is approve them all except for Silver Threads and then do a...
Oh, okay.
I will move that we approve them all with the exception of Silver Threads.
Second.
Okay, those in favor, opposed, carried. Susan gets out. Somebody moves Silver Threads.
Move Silver Threads.
Second. Favor, opposed, carried. Susan comes back.
You're going very far.
Okay, so am I done with number three? Okay, so item number four, first on page 10. If you want Paul to walk through it, if you read it, I'll do it. And then in addition, he has also provided information on how reduction in funding expenses, 315, can be accomplished. So your lift would be 2.16 plus 0.34 plus 75 for 325. Well, what do you want? Do you want to walk through it?
I'm curious why now we're moving it even further down and what removing this money out of this fund will do.
Why don't you walk through it?
The facility capital contingency budget concerns you when we take money out of facilities.
I'm sorry, the budget document is pretty well the document that you saw through the budget process. And a few adjustments. We talked about allocating out the contingency for BC Hydro increases and employment insurance and long-term disability. So you see a few of the percentages change throughout a variety of departments a little bit. It's because we've taken the contingency from finance and allocated it out to the departments now that we know that there is an EI increase, there will be an LTD increase, premium increase, and there will be a hydro increase. So a variety of those filtering through. We've made a few changes to some of the capital budgets. The large one really is just prorating Craig Flower Bridge over 2 years instead of all in one, because we know we're not going to get $10 million worth of work done this year. So we're just showing, I think, $1.5 million or so this year as the starting point. So capital programs reduced by several million, but it's just simply allocating over the 2 years. The mayor had asked for what would it take to reduce down a little bit more. If you recall, we had a conversation a couple of weeks ago about if we did receive an additional property tax revenue from new construction, that would go towards facilities and top up the 0.75% that we were doing by policy. Mm-hmm. So what we did in the proposal was build that. So there was, in fact, close to $1 million in additional capital spending allocated towards facilities this year. So all this does is pull it back to the 0.75%. And so in effect, what it does is reduces from 3.6, the average homeowner, to 3.25. But it still maintains you putting that extra spending into facilities. What it means is some of the new construction taxation is just going towards funding operating costs instead of increasing capital spending. Mm-hmm. And it has the effect of reducing down the tax levy by $300,000 or so.
But, I mean, the report you gave us shows some significant investments we have to do in other facilities. So by reducing this down, takes that money out of, and I want to escalate how much further we'll have to go into whatever plan we're going to do.
It does, and the issue is that we need to refine those numbers through that facility strategic plan and determine if they are like we were talking about. And so that wouldn't happen until at least the fall. So a lot of this money is likely not to be spent until next year anyway.
If you look on page 82 of the binder. So it stood out for me on page 82. Major facilities capital contingency.
I don't know if I'm on 82, doesn't say that. No. Community facilities, rec facilities.
Yeah,
on
and if you go down that financial, it was third to last line, or second to last line.
Oh, right, so that's my injury.
No. See the $1.4 million?
Oh, maybe facilities.
It's in contingencies. We haven't even identified what to spend it on. So that's where I thought our tax increase is higher than, well, some are zero and less than two, but others are just squeaking over three. Our tax increase is going to be the largest in the region, and yet we're putting money into contingencies.
specific project, say $1 million would be spent on perks or Cedar Hill, etc. No, we don't. We're in the process of doing that. The discussion we had was about doing a variety of assessments over the summer, which is about $200,000 worth of work, which is identified here. Coming back with a refined set of facility numbers, determining what the annual spending target should be to achieve that proper infrastructure replacement for facilities, and then developing a 25-year facility plan. What this does is it just, in fact, puts you back 1 year slightly.
So taking the $315,000 out of this fund, are you saying that it will, with new development, that fund would be topped up again or not for another year?
Certainly, that would be our suggestion, and if we're able to do that in each case, if our new construction revenue ended up being a little higher than what we project, mm-hmm. and in this case this year it was a little bit high, we tend to be a bit conservative when we start because we don't know what appeals are going to go through BC assessment, particularly when you have a large property owner, you could have quite a swing if there was a successful appeal. We, a week and a half ago, got the completed role and got our new numbers, and so there's about $300,000 additional that, based on the prior discussion with council, we would put forward into facilities. The options there are simply not to do that and put that towards operating cost, and that has the effect of reducing the tax rate settlement.
So I can understand the rationale. My concern is I don't want us to start hiving off this, and then we're going to have a bigger hit on our facilities as we ramp up whatever the program is.
It's still,
it's going to take a year.
Still going to explain to the taxpayers there's still a 0.75. Yeah.
No, I know that's not for facilities.
But we're not doing 0.75 plus new construction.
Yeah.
We're doing 0.75.
And the 0.75 is being allocated towards facilities this
year. Yes, not the report you gave us, right? That's the one that I think is a big hit. Okay.
So, if you're looking for some consensus, I totally support the proposal of being for the 3.25. We're not interfering with our policy. That stays intact. But I think it's just not in any messages that I'm getting from our taxpayers. They want us to be leading the parade on the spending, so I think they would appreciate any efforts that we can to try and keep it down as low as we can.
And we still need to make it clear to everybody that it's 2.5% for year to year, and 0.75 additional for
infrastructure. Right, exactly. So
they're trying to compare us to other jurisdictions. Squamish 2%, we're 2.5, but somebody else's.
Yeah.
It's the year to year is 2.5. The 0.75 list is what we've done for close to 10 years. It's a policy decision. It's 2.5 plus 0.75 for communications. Guess I'm going to try that.
Just a question and a comment. Okay, to meet your facilities capital contingency of 1.6, is that the accumulation of the 0.75 we put in every year?
There's a level of core funding that's already established, which is about $700,000 or so. We've increased it by $675,000 this year, which is that 0.75. So that's ongoing. That stays there each year. And hopefully next year, if we're able to follow that policy again and add another 0.75, you would see that increase to $2.1 million or so.
Okay. So in total, 40 years that we've collected 0.75, how much do we have there then?
I think this is the fourth year?
Fifth year.
Fifth year. So that's 3.75%. So close to $3 million additional capital spending that's there each year now.
Yeah.
So that's so we've increased our annual capital spend by $3 million over the last 5 years.
Okay.
We need to get to about $40 million. We're currently at about 22,
yeah,
24.
Okay. I guess the only concern I do have. And I shouldn't say I'm not concerned what other municipalities do and what their taxes are. And I like to see low taxes for Saanich too. But I do remember being part of a townhouse development where most of the people in it thought they had $20,000 in their fund, which would just cover, anything. And coming back to a couple million dollars, most of our infrastructure today is fairly new. 10, 15, 20 years down the road, we're going to have a lot coming on for replacement. And to cut back on it, especially when it has been said that we should probably be looking at 1.2 or 2.5 in that range, and we're saying, well, let's put it off. And next year when the sewage treatment starts kicking in, and the next year after that when we have an election coming up, I don't see those as prime years to raise that, you know, 7.5 up to 1 or 1.25. And myself, I'd like to see it happen this year, not next year. And I don't think we should be playing with it.
Okay.
But if we got it in the ground, we have to replace it.
Okay, life wants 3.6.
Not in this economy life, for me, anyway. And I don't think we do a, I really like the 0.75 that we put in there. And I don't think we do a good enough job of telling people. They just want to look at the bottom line. But I think that's really, really important. And 2.16, 0.34 new services, 0.75 capital. Let's promote that, because I think it's a really good news story. And unfortunately, the taxpayer sees the bottom line. And if they look beyond that, they'll see that we're doing something really sustainable.
I support 3.25. I'm mindful that we are going to have more demand, but the economy right now, just can't. I can't go.
So Paul, the report around our facilities and the buildings we own, you're going to bring us a report this year on a game plan of how we're going to get a handle on it? Because I agree with Life. I think it would be foolish for a council to head off into an election year with raising the taxes, whatever it might be, through whatever the report says, as opposed to slowly escalating that 0.75 up to where we need to get it. So we'll have a report this year, and we'll be able to make some sort of decisions this year.
Yeah, through the chair, yeah, I'm hopeful of that. We need to do several assessments of buildings during the summer, so provided that those assessments are done, and by all accounts we think we can do them, pull them all together in September, I'd expect to be back to council with some kind of discussion in October.
Okay, thanks. Oh, and can I just ask a question about, whenever we talk about taxation, is it, we say on average assessment, whatever it is this year, how many average assessment type dwellings do we have in Saanich? You know, it's like saying on average assessment, and then someone else says, well, I'm going to, you know, more than that. So do you have a percentage?
I really don't. There's
45,000, whatever?
Yeah, there's about 39,000, 40,000 homes, portfolios. There's a pretty standard bell curve. If you look at the demographic of them, you're going to get a few properties that are fairly low priced. There's a lot right around the middle, and some high priced. It's not skewed one way or the other. But to give you a particular list, we've got to do a fair amount of work to do that, because we simply can't get that from BC Assessment. We have to.
And your gut, you don't have a gut feeling that, you know, of the folios, 50% are average?
No, it wouldn't be that. I would say if you're seeing, if the average value is $622,000, I'd say it's probably 3 or 4%. There's some that would be 620,000, 622, 625, 630.
Oh, okay.
There's a real spread. There's a good chunk right around the middle.
Yeah.
We could probably take a look at that and see what that proportion is. And I guess it's probably 40% of the properties are within a reasonable distance of the average.
Okay.
And then, you know, you've got the waterfront and
yeah,
the high price descent. And,
thanks, Mr. Baer. Given that we are in the process of studying the numbers that we need to generate, I think I can support 3.25 this year. But we all know that we are going to have to move it up. And I think we all know as a council also that the reason we have to move it up is past councils trying to artificially keep the tax rate down. And that's not just in Saanich, it's all over the place. So there never was, or in most places, there never was a situation where infrastructure and maintenance replacement is adequately funded. So we need to get to that. This is a relatively small bump in the road, but we won't be able to have many more bumps, I don't think.
Just the other thing for perspective, when this report comes in the
so I think that's the other thing we've got to look at in the fall. We've been told that our debt service level is extremely conservative. And I think, you know, we can discuss that with our taxpayers, that it's reasonable to have a higher debt limit. If we're putting it into hard capital with long-term life, you can make a good business plan.
Short-term and long-term profit, it's good.
Okay, so the motion's on the floor, I believe, for the recommendation at 3.25.
Has that been made?
Yeah, you made it.
You too made it.
It was a very intelligent move.
Oh, I thought you did, I'm sorry.
I spoke in favor of it, but I'll move it.
Okay, so you did now?
I'm now moving it.
Okay, Andrew's up now. Those in favor, opposed? I'm opposed. Carry. Remuneration. Page 13, lucky 13. So the last box is consistent with what we've done last year and I don't know if the year before too. Okay, so last year we did just identical to the last box, which includes equipment. The year before that we included equipment, but we phased.
Yeah, so why did we exclude equipment?
Because they've become a rogue.
But they got the same population as us almost dead on.
Just look what they've done.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, just no way you're moving me out the window. I think to be consistent, it's the same list we use for a lot of comparisons, because it's the population spread.
Yeah.
Equipment should be there because we use it for exam, we use it for other comparisons.
Yeah.
So I think we should continue to do the survey, but in a practical sense, to you can see what happens if you include it in them.
And that was 2 years ago, so we anticipate we would probably be doing another raise.
Cool. Richard Stewart.
I'll move the bottom box.
Okay.
Second?
Okay. You ready for that? Those in favor? Opposed? Carry. Okay, so this is now I adjourn committee. Ask for a motion to adjourn committee.
So moved.
Second.
In favor? Opposed? Carry. Call to order council. So the first resolution is to Cadver Bay.
Move the BIA.
So seconder? Somebody's Dick seconded. Okay, those in favor? Opposed? Carry. So our referral from committee is the first one's community matching grants. On the recommendation.
Move. No, I'm not gonna make comment. It's unfortunate. Fortunate for Dean in many ways, but unfortunately for Dean isn't here. I can be honest, I looked at this and I was pretty surprised. In other years, we've tried, and originally this was set up to take well-known associations within Saanich, our community associations primarily, and allow them to have a project in process, similar to what happened on a very large scale in Seattle. And wow, now, I mean, we for years I said we would want to be away, keeping away from schools and community schools and things of that nature. And we have things in here that the World Fisheries Trust, I just, you know, in our community matching grant, that, like I said, they're a bad organization, but I really don't know how to interpret this. And we get some people who have asked for around 2,000 for invasive plant removal, and they get $400, and somebody else gets $1,800, and some people get $700. I just don't know about the process anymore.
Yep.
Yes, I'd like to comment too. I certainly remember when Healthy Saanich brought the idea of this through from Seattle, and Vic and I with the scan, we worked on this to make the matching grant, and it was for community association to work for some assets, the community. I'm looking at this and all these cleaning up invasive species and working with the Ploy Together program, and you're right in the criteria, it's not to duplicate what we have. So what about the other 25 groups that are up doing the same thing that happen to look forward to, wow, I could get a few bucks here. So it's not consistent. And I also go through and I look at this, how about Burton Community Organic Farm? They're in the other project grant. Peninsula Streams, I mean, they're talking about School District 63, very regional. It says they did one day at the Royal Oak School, $1,000. Shoreline Community School, I mean, we've been quite adamant that we didn't support that. They refer to a grant and aid. World Fisheries Trust, I mean, they've got huge dollars coming from elsewhere. This certainly, to me, does not represent anything what the matching grant is supposed to be. I also go to the Cabot Bay Residents Association, funding for bottled water, when we have said we were removing bottled water from municipal facilities. So I'm sorry. I'm having, you know, apart from the Friends of Todd Creek Watershed, which they obviously do have matches and are doing something, and maybe Meltview, Colquitt Community Association, and their community gardens, I'm not terribly supportive of the whole recommendation.
Well, you should put the money in the budget and defer the actual grants. The money's in the budget. You don't have to do the grants right now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was chair of Healthy Saanich when we brought this forward, and it really was based on the Seattle Department of Neighborhoods Community Matching Grant. It was to provide neighborhoods with a sense of pride in their neighborhood. So we would partner, we'd give them some money, and they'd pony up some labor, and there'd be something in their neighborhood that they could reflect on. So I too was very concerned when I saw about programming. You know, the Shoreline Community School, I mean, I've been approached by the council, different members on the Royal Council, and I said, you know what, Saanich puts in a lot of money into youth programs. Free ones, drop-in ones, and so if we're gonna start funding school, other organizations, I'm not sure how that would relate to the stuff we do as well. World Trust, Fisheries Trust, I looked at them, I went online, I thought, wow, they've got tons of money. And this, the money they want, is just for them to set up at a bunch of the venues. I don't think we've ever been approached about some organization that wants to set up their thing at Cabaret Bay Days or Gorge Telecom Picnic, and that's what their money's for, is to set up at these groups. So, I'm a little nervous that we're going down this path. If council wants to, and Nicola will remember this, if council wants to revisit what this community matching grant is, then I think we should do it. But I don't think we should be opening up programs. You know, it was never about programming. It was about something pride, neighborhood pride. Mm-hmm. The troll under the bridge in Seattle, the pocket gardens, that sort of stuff. So that's my comment.
Susan, and then Mike.
Having chaired so many years, I am just so in awe of Dean that he timed his family around. Anyway, you know, it's great what it was set up for. It has evolved apparently into something else. We did review the terms of reference 2 years ago, and we as a council supported the change terms of reference. If there's anything in here that offends the guidelines, I say take it out. But if it's not just heading in a direction that was dreamed of, I see they didn't even grant all the money that was available to them, and I know that's happened on many years. It seems that the hoped for communities coming together for trolls under bridges isn't happening. And so this is highly supported by SCAN. They are involved in this right up to every dollar of the recommendation. I say if we don't take this, we've basically said to that committee and to the community representatives on it that we don't have confidence in them. And I'd only be prepared to look at ones. If somebody could say that there is a guideline that we have that these don't meet, I'd say I support taking it. Otherwise, I support going with it and abolish it if it's not meeting our need in the future. But it's down to an invasive species clean out and a few other odd things. These kind of hoped for seeds to start something in the community are not supported at the community level. They're not coming forward with those requests.
It's interesting. I think this one item has been a problem every year. I don't think we've learned too much from it. I guess keeping it simple, I'd be much happier to see something like this, is give every community $1,000 and say, please go and do something good. And that's about what we're doing here. It's just, that would make more sense than what we have here, I think. But coming back to the groups, they're going to look at this and say, you know, I only got $50 and you got $100, you know why? And I think it's created a lot of confusion.
Well, one of the things that happened with community associations, they found an issue of consistency, and then they found that it became quite bureaucratic to apply for it, because a number of them contacted me and let me know that. North Quadra, for example, did a lot of tree planting, and they applied one year and were told, well, tree planting is no longer eligible. So they went to Tree Canada and a whole variety of other things, but you know, that was the thing they were trying to do. In Seattle, when we set it up, one of their feature projects was a woman had organized planting of 6,000 trees in the neighborhood. But, you know, they were simply told, you're not eligible, that's not eligible. So they gave up, and that happened a lot.
It had to be more than 7 years ago, Vic, because I followed this thing closely for the last 7 years.
It may have been more, it may have been more than 7 years ago.
No requests for trees.
It's come here, I don't know, it's become a weird beast.
Okay, who's going to figure it out over here? Everybody.
Well, I'm prepared to support some of these, but I'm not prepared to support all of them. I mean, I look at the guidelines here. It says should add to rather than duplicate existing private or public program. The pulling together program is out there every weekend in every park. So some of these are smart enough to apply for some money through a matching grant. Well, the rest of them aren't. So, I mean, this is just repeating a program that is being done already in this park. So there's that comment, and these other ones that we've talked about, the shoreline, rural fisheries, peninsula streams, I certainly wouldn't support them at all. But there are a few that I think do follow the guidelines, but, you know, unless we, and in particular I wouldn't support those, but, you know, unless we want to do some sort of vague thing and say, you know, nix for next year on the invasive species like we did with the trees, because we were just having too many more trees than we needed. But I'm not just carte blanche saying, no, I support.
So tonight, the amount's in the budget, so that's fine. We could approve those if there's consensus on some of them, and if some of them there isn't a consensus, we could defer until Dean was here to defend himself.
Oh, throw himself right on the sword.
Well, I don't know how many there's not consensus around. It sounds like there's 3 or 4.
Well, I was going to say, Frank, it's not fair on Dean. He's not here, and he did say if we have a problem with this, we should contact him.
Well, there's a note.
There is a note.
Yeah, because he gave his reasons.
He said they met and they did the best of good.
And there is a note.
It meets with the policy. And,
that's Twitter right now.
You're right. We have. We've gone off the rails with this. I sat on that committee some few years, and it worked well. But it was definitely community oriented. Mm-hmm. And remember, we got the Victoria players or something.
Shakespeare
players. They wanted, you know, they came in. I don't know how that one ever came in. And we've got Halliburton's Devil Dipping.
Well, Victoria.
So, you know, and the World Fisheries Trust, as you say, they've got a ton of money. Peninsula Stream Society. So, it's definitely gone off the rails. We need to have a look at it again.
Yeah,
Well, there are no rails. Yes, if you try to guide your train over this thing, there are no rails.
There were rails. There were rails.
So, I'm gonna try and work this through. We have the money in the budget, so I think the Pierce Crescent Park and Play Area is along the lines of what we were talking about when this started. So I'd support that.
I support that.
Well, how about if I go down?
Okay.
If there's, how many people here? 8. If we have a consensus on an item, it'll get the grant tonight. If there isn't consensus, we'll defer and not repeat it. How's that?
Okay.
So, Lancashire, the Pierce Crescent thing, is it consensus?
Yes.
Okay. The Cadre Bay Festival?
Well, I'm sort of question, is this during Sunfest time? How is this different than what they usually do during the, their little sandcastle building?
Yeah. It's referred for more information.
Funding will not be provided retroactively for projects started prior to that. You know, they do the festival every year under Sunfest.
So do you want to defer or
defer?
I think defer.
Okay.
They didn't get
Backwood Park. Federal Day was recommended to zero. Yeah. So Beckwith is invasive plant removal, so that's...
Unless we're going to get out of funding any invasive plant removal, I say support it. I mean, this community...
And let the other groups know that they can apply.
Okay, so we're going to have every park that has a steward is going to apply. I'm applying next year.
We funded this for years, yeah, so you could have applied again this year.
But there was no pulling together program before. This is a new program.
So what's the together program? Why weren't these people advised of it?
I
have no idea. They're even they've got letters of support from the pulling together program. It doesn't make any sense.
So you're not there.
No.
So you want to defer. I've just said if there's eight of us, if not eight, we defer.
Okay.
I don't want to split votes. So then the next one's a defer too? Okay.
And the next
one. And the next one's different.
So Friends of Todd Creek Watershed, theirs is different though, and they've got partners and such on that, and they've got funding from other partners. So it's not just a pulling together project.
It's a restoration.
It's a restoration. I don't have a problem with
that. Where's that?
It's the Friends of Todd Creek
Watershed.
Yeah, it is. Well, Friends of Todd Creek. So we're in favor of that.
Yeah. I don't know why they only got $500.
Okay.
Yeah.
So the Gorge Park sign.
Yes.
Yes.
Communities, Halliburton, we're saying is a double dip.
Yeah.
It's a defer.
Mm-hmm. Sorry.
Maybe it's going to be a refer, which means go back to Dean's committee to have one more discussion before he brings it back.
Oh.
Well, might as well.
Yeah, I know. I agree.
I'd say, can we use the word refer?
Refer. Sure, refer it back to them.
Yeah. Okay.
Refer.
After this last week.
That'll be legal anyways.
Yeah. Yeah. A weed whackers, that's good. Send it back for the reefers.
Okay, so the Canuckson is also a reefer?
Yeah, it's
the same category?
Yeah.
Mount View.
No,
go
that's okay.
Yeah.
Peninsula Streams is a reefer.
Refer, I can see it's a reefer.
Because it's over the blue.
Yeah.
I think we funded it last year. Just FYI.
We've done before.
Yeah, FYI, we did. Yeah, so.
The Brook we've done before. Shoreline we've said no to.
Yeah, a number of times at council.
Okay, so it's a refer, and I don't know what the other one is.
It's a mobile.
Okay, so we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 we've approved, and the rest are referred, and the whole amount stays in the budget.
Well, I think it carries forward too. Even if you didn't spend it all, it would just carry forward, and that's how the grant program.
So we're at council, so I need a motion to approve the 5.
Second.
Those in favor? Those carried. And a motion to refer the balance back to the committee.
So moved.
Second.
Okay. Question figured out.
Okay.
I'm just waiting for a second. Are we of the mind that we are, over the next 6 months, going to look at the whole grant program?
No, I'm just referring this back to Dean's committee.
No.
This is a simple motion.
I realize this is. At what point do we look at
if you would like to do that, we'd be happy for you to do that.
I appreciate that. Yeah. Thank you.
Everybody says it, and nobody really wants to break them up. But. So you, I mean, staff have given you if it's consistent with our strategic priorities.
But in the grant document says examples of projects include park improvement, playground equipment, celebration.
No, but I think let's talk about
the big.
Oh, you're talking about the big grant for
this? $500,000.
Yeah.
No, he's just not going with the $11,000. He's talking about $500,000.
We just say yes every year, but that's as far as it goes.
We didn't. We said no lots of times. This is just on the motion on the $11,000 minus 5 projects being referred back to whatever he's called.
And will the committee get our comments?
Yeah,
I think they have to have our comments.
All of them.
Yeah.
Okay, can I call the question?
Okay,
those in favor? Opposed? Carried?
You asked
me to call the question. Okay, the library budget. We need a resolution to approve the library budget.
So, second.
Favor? Opposed? Carried?
move.
Second.
Those in favor, opposed, carried. So those will come back in the form of bylaws now. Anything else, Susan?
On the grant request slash community, I did not step out, and I should.
So we should have had a separate motion for it?
Yeah.
Okay, sorry. Okay, so we should rescind that.
Okay.
We rescind it.
Second.
Those in favor, opposed, carried. So now I'll have a motion on community grants for everything except social grants.
So moved.
Second.
Those in favor, opposed, carried. Susan gets out. So we have a 2B.
Move Silver Thread.
Second.
Those in favor, opposed, carried. Now, Susan, thanks for catching me on that, Susan. Okay. Everybody got their homework?
Yeah.
Done?
Thank you.
Motion adjourned.
So moved.
Those in favor, opposed, carried. No?
Don't.
I don't know if I'm going to say we adjourned or not.
I just wanted to ask this question.
Yours can be, yes.
Are we as comfortable, do we want to review the grant process? Because if we don't bring it up now, we'll be here next year saying, let's do it different.
I don't know what you're going to accomplish. I'll make a tough decision about $500,000 for the grants.
And it's not just that, you know, you could look at.
I just don't know a formula that's going to make it any easier. I actually think we're doing pretty good compared to most councils. You know, one night presentations, less than an hour, we get it done.
I think for those that apply for it, they do very well. But they're just the wise ones that know about the process.
Lots of supply and we don't support them.
There's a fair amount of zeros.
Yeah, we cut it down.
There are a number of other meetings that are agonizing through the same thing about the arbitrary.
I'm going to get to the wisdom of council.
I didn't say it's wisdom, it's will.